Hey guys, it's your boy Compares, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool career mode where last time I left off. I picked up a win in over Wolfsburg in the first leg of in the last 16. Tied them in a Champions League. So I'm 3-0 up, hanging into the second leg. And he won a game in the FA Cup against Chesterfield to go into the quarter final of that competition as well. Cool. And to complete the trifecta, the League Cup is here. The final against Chelsea. Time to acquire the first bit of silverware for the League Cup, the of the season. Cup, and of course, that means a trip to Wembley.
What a prize to play for. Yeah,
big chance. See how each of us got to the final. Well, I beat Plymouth.
Chelsea playing Liverpool with a great history of the fixture and some wonderful games in recent seasons as well between the two when they've
should have been quicker on that. you guys can go.
Plenty of history between these two teams.
You might pause. You could have easily paused it.
So here we go, in the final of the English League Cup. Well, it's a magnificent atmosphere within this stadium, and I'm expecting a superb game.
Not that it matters in the slightest.
Big reshuffle.
It's come game day. It doesn't matter who you beat and who you didn't.
Daniel Klein starts with David Alaba as the fullbacks.
Dele Alli starts with Bruno
Sanchez in central midfield.
Of course.
Strike force.
Saying that, you
shut off now.
Beat teams you didn't come up against.
Deflected behind. A clear corner.
Relatively, I had a really easy run to the final this year.
I'll never be afraid to shoot.
Not coming up against any notable teams up until now.
Nemanja Matic. Robert Lewandowski.
I'm sure Chelsea
here's Renato.
Remember the
looked dangerous until he made the interception.
Hiding I gave him. Towards the back end of the
now with Liverpool
last year.
And here's the shot.
The previous year.
Well, that assistant there, he was certain.
Sorry, Divock, is not a goal. Because you were offside. That's why I did not celebrate. Indeed.
But we get the advantage of another look that the officials, of course, don't.
I mean, no, Mane wouldn't be much better. He was further off. Call,
but the defence had squeezed and caught the lad offside, although he tucked it away well. Mikel.
Makes me wonder. I think in this game that is the case. What I'm thinking.
A bit early, gets a bit.
What I was thinking is, since Mane was offside, if Divock Origi had been on, I think it would still been flagged because the ball could have easily found its way to Mane.
To find an opening.
Or whatever the game bullshit logic would have been. But Origi was offside, so it doesn't matter. But had he been on, it was just Mane.
Attacking now.
Pissed.
Opportunity to cross it now.
You can bet. There's the break. That side, they will finally.
This League Cup final.
Is a lot. You never mind. We've
just seen an excellent one there.
Not that it matters. It's 1-0 anyway. Divock Origi opens the scoring on the 19th minute.
Different angle on it here.
Leaving Courtois nice and dumbfounded.
That has opened the scoring. 1-0 here.
Rooted to the spot. As the case is.
The opposition
scoring begins.
They've tried to play it into the wide area.
Get a few more goals secure for my place.
To pick out
that third League Cup trophy in 3 years. Will
they've
be
got a chance in this part of the pitch.
3 seasons, I should specify.
The referee had a good look at that, decided it's just a throw after the tackle. Divock Origi. He'll need to try and get the ball back now. He can cross it now. And there is some backup. And now the shot.
Ooh.
Fine save. And now they've got a corner on the attack again, the team that's leading by one goal.
Dinger.
He has it.
Hurt the old arm.
In midfield, they've got it back via an interception.
Game shots blasted. I don't know what I'm talking about.
On the attack here.
Renato Sanchez. Ah, just as I was about to shoot again. This game seems to really love cutting me off just at the crucial moment. I don't think it's doing it intentionally. I really don't. I think it's just getting extremely fucking lucky. Makes it more annoying.
In goes the tackle. It's a corner because of it.
Or don't. Come on, get the second goal here. Terrible header straight at Courtois. It's a thumbs up for a terrible
here quite clearly. An attempted pass, not a good one. He went in well. Eden Hazard. Mikel. Nemanja Matic. That's going to run on through to the goalkeeper. And the decision for the added time is 3 minutes. Chelsea making the chances that they should do because they've got more possession, but they're losing.
Yeah, I mean, the opposition are withdrawing, so you'd expect Chelsea to have the ball, but they haven't been good enough in possession so far.
Looking good, this move.
Mane. To Origi. 2-0! Get in! A brace from Divock Origi. And just before half-time, looking like it's another red year for the EFL Cup.
Goalkeeper was reaching for it, and it did actually touch him on the way in.
I think there was just too much power on the ball and the shot for him to get a strong enough touch.
Lovely stuff, gentlemen, lovely stuff.
27. English League Cup final half.
As if to really rub it in Chelsea's gaping wounds. Referee's like, yeah, I'm gonna blow it half almost pretty much immediately.
Has had its first half. Here goes the second half. We're underway.
Yeah, it can be drying in this pitch, and going into the second half further into it, maybe tiredness will play a part.
Made the challenge well.
Good take from Renato Sanchez. Good position. Go, Renato.
Attacked very well into a quite a dangerous position there.
And they'll be winning their first trophies as Liverpool players.
Nathaniel Clyne. They cope with it well defensively. Well, a real treat in store for you. Coverage on EA Sports of the.
I can only assume Renato Sanchez won a few.
West Ham United.
Bundesliga titles, considering he was previously at Bayern Munich.
An easy one for the Lions. He was a good couple of yards.
I don't know that for sure. I don't think Bayern have the dominance in the game that they do in real life. The game can throw up some odd outcomes.
Well, they've been really bursting to get on, those players on the bench, and one's going to be lucky now. There's the ball in. Defender to it first.
Substitution. Now they've got to defend this. Prevents corner. The cross reaching Mane or
Alan, what about
Origi.
At
the expense of a corner. Mane!
High class header and a world class save.
Well, you could argue it was a good height for him, but what reflexes, what agility he showed there.
Tight call, but he's made it. The flag's up.
Some relieved faces. amongst those defenders there. I think they thought the flag was going to stay down.
And it's Dele Alli.
An hour of very good football here. We've still got 30 more minutes to go, and I'm sure we're going to...
What's the challenge? Origi! Hat-trick! That is surely that. A Divock Origi hat-trick.
It's a wonderful hat-trick.
Should sign, seal, and deliver three consecutive League Cup for Liverpool.
Well, no wonder he's wheeling away in a super celebration to get a hat-trick.
I mean, Courtois will be kicking himself.
Done that. Well, having scored,
really, on all three goals, he could probably have done a lot better. He could have easily kept out all three, which is not exactly what you want from your star goalkeeper, especially in a cup final. Hell, in any game, in a situation where you're like, he could have done better there. Especially when you know the keeper is of that top quality. I mean, if your keeper is someone like Mignolet, where you know he can make a few mistakes, you're always on the prowl for it. But Courtois, you know, you expect much better from him.
Fantastic save! 20 minutes now remaining. Could be dangerous. Heads it towards goal.
Mane, there we go. Finally, one he really couldn't do much about.
Not picked up.
Shame that makes it 4-0 and definitely wraps up the League Cup. I think Courtois knows this and he's shaking his head. He's like,
saw it coming from a long way.
This is just getting worse and worse.
Just
now.
Perfect from the delivery to the finish. Top marks.
Decides to throw his name in the players who scored a goal in the NFL Cup. To be fair, I think this is the first game he's played since last season in the competition. So, yeah.
Now Van Hinkel. Chelsea given the advantage.
If he has made any Euro appearances, they've been at the
Silk. This could be it. And here's the shot.
Dele Alli. 5-0.
Like most things he does, he's got an air of grace about it.
It's just racking up now.
It is.
Mane turns provider this time and puts it on a plate for Dele Alli.
Should be home and hosed.
To score his fifth Liverpool goal.
Bill and the game underway again. Rafael Varane.
It's just piling on now.
Now Van Hinkel. Liverpool take over possession again.
Really, Nicholas? Did you really have to get in the way of that?
Have the pain to get the gain, and they've suffered these supporters sometimes, but. It's gained today. It's a goalkeeper.
Carrius comes claiming. No problem.
Love that.
Get that away from the goal. Riggy's going to get good there,
position.
You know.
They've worked this attack very well. Into a quite a dangerous position now. Liverpool will get the throw. Dele Alli. Now he's looking
Dele
for support.
Alli.
Now the shot!
Full confidence, but never really gonna go in, was it?
Well, this is not what Chelsea came here expecting, and they're being shocked by what's happening to them. Rafael Varane, and it's gonna be an attacking move this from Chelsea. Wembley Stadium,
please give it's out for a goal kick.
Number 27, Divock Origi.
Not on my.
So there'll be a good chunk added on. It's going to be 4 minutes.
Or Mane.
Good place to win the ball.
Coutinho. It's there one more goal in this game? Yes, indeed there is. And just before he lifts his first trophy since I am captain, Philippe Coutinho decides, you know what? I think this game needs a sixth goal. Oh, they don't better get it than me.
Pretty straightforward, this match.
Top quality, Phil. Top quality.
Just compounded their superiority with that one. Well, the match a long time over here. 6-0 now. Nemanja Matic. Well, there is the final whistle.
Chelsea are put out of their misery. The game is finally over. If you're Chelsea,
yeah, absolute joy amongst those players. They've worked long and hard, haven't they? Over the
I want to leave on the celebrations, but I don't want them to go too long.
Boy, they deserve it.
Game time of the West Ham.
These are special moments.
This shouldn't take too long.
A very successful team. Congratulations to them.
I wish I could skip past this and get to them, you know, going up and getting the trophy.
Wonderful scenes but of joy here.
And say, no wonder they're milking the moment. I
want to make absolutely the most of this.
Well, the whole point of having these cuts
stuck together, defended really well in this competition, and snatched the goals at the vital times. So, fully deserved winners. There they go. They are the champions!
Hey, there we go. Wonderful. As I said, I would normally watch the whole thing and leave them running, but unfortunately, that's normally Watford was their team, sorry.
English League Cup final.
Brentford.
Liverpool.
Was that
six,
last? Oh, that was last season, two. Wasn't it?
Swansea City 1, Manchester City 2.
Hang on, did Man City play their game in hand? Oh, they did. And they won it. You know, that's what I was expecting. I was expecting them to win it. So 25 points is the gap with 13 games left. I mean, that's 5 games. Just going to put that out there. That's 5 victories. Jeez. At most. As well. That doesn't necessarily mean I have to get 5 victories. If other teams drop points, I'll be champions sooner. I wonder, will you get go up despite the fact that he's injured, because he's really close. Grujic is actually really close to being an A1 rated player. Let's get him up. Who else is... Calabria, let's get him to an A rated player. And since he's going to be playing in this next game, I'm going to put Feor in as well. Oh wow, both Feors went up. It's like some crazy coincidence. I'm going to switch around just yet. So I don't get any unnecessary and unwanted emails. Make sure I don't forget this time. A few more changes, like putting in Mokanu to partner up with. Gotze, he's been, you know, sitting on the bench for a while. Let's get the blood flowing in his legs again, and you know, put the regulars back in the team, being Shea Ojo. Oh well, the second team regulars really. well, I guess you could say they're all, almost all of our second team regulars, except Mario Götze. Who, to be honest, I've been kind of ignoring, to be honest, which is a bit unfair of me. Yeah, this is his opportunity to make sure that it's rectified. Let's see, we want Man City. Oh, beautiful, beautiful. They are playing Man United. Best time for Man United to come along and play in Manchester City. To be honest, that's pretty much like in real life, except Liverpool were not chasing the title in real life, we're chasing top four. The two of them still have to play each other. But it's brilliant enough for that. One of them will drop 3 points, or they'll both drop two. Be fantastic. I don't know when that game is happening. Okay. Let's get that up and going. Of course, post this week's weekend. This game. By this weekend, I mean this weekend. Gone. This is of course recorded on Saturday, but it's posted. Sorry, no. Wait, is this? No, today's Friday. Sorry, long weekend. I'm so freaking disjointed. I forgot Thursday was yesterday. It feels like a normal weekend.
Just to remind you, everyone, Liverpool have the best home record in this league.
Nobody really can come close, can they? With 13 wins in 13 games, they'll be hoping to continue that here.
That's one of those, isn't it?
Man United kicking up. This is the Liverpool side.
So this has been reported on Friday.
Like Martin, yes, it's the conventional shape. It's the one
posted
the manager prefers.
On Monday.
West Ham United's lineup is this. Havard Norveit plays. Shots on here. It's a fine strike, but not quite what he was hoping for.
But when he's hit it, I'm sure he would have thought that was going to bulge in the back of the net. Not quite, though.
Calabria. Really trying to use the full width of the pitch.
No, hang on. No, sorry. This is the Wednesday video.
Well, this attack got a bit of menace to it.
Yeah, this I only need to record my secondary promo videos and my Uncharted video. Where no doubt I'm gonna die like five more times per episode until the end of time.
Checo Kvyat, a couple of teammates who are clearly on the same wavelength. Tackle goes in. It's looking good.
It's gonna be a weird moment, weird episode.
He's shut off now. He's reached it.
Die.
And turned it aside. They cope with it well defensively.
It's gonna be a weird but welcome episode.
Place to win it back. Götze.
Götze.
Done the goalkeeper, and he's hung on to the ball.
They've done better that by that, to be honest.
Liverpool.
Sturridge.
Here's the shots in it.
Oh, I could have done better with that as well. Are you kidding me, man?
Good progress with this attack. That attack was looking good. Now the opposition have a chance. In quickly. On Andre Ayew. Attacking well here. Mario Götze.
Götze. Shea Ojo.
Here, challenge. It's a good one. Sturridge.
Sturridge. 1-0.
Pressure for Daniel Sturridge. Exceptional. And this is another example of his remarkable finishing talents. Well, it's a very good goal and much deserved the way the team are playing.
Yeah, the stats don't...
I don't know how he does that. I really don't.
It's no surprise that they've scored.
I mean, it just looks like he's... He makes it look complicated. He's just moving his fucking arms. I don't know.
Had a third of the game.
What I do know is it's 1-0 and number 15, Daniels. On track. It's
could be dangerous. Could be a chance here for Liverpool.
Get a second. Penalty.
Stopped emphatically and just as well. The approach play looked very encouraging. He's blocked the shot well.
I think the top contenders to take it were Ben Sturridge himself and probably got
to. Trying to switch on the attacking power in this situation. It could be a chance!
Ooh! Winston Reid. They attempt to help out. Almost put West Ham 2-0 down.
And he goes for goal with his head. Well, that's a good corner in the circumstances. Didn't seem to hit the ball properly.
These corners aren't going as planned, are they?
Don't you? Whether he's trying to be too precise or whatever.
Liverpool leading.
Would it be fair to say that?
Pretty slender margin at this stage. We've got half-time coming up, and they want to get there with this lead still intact. Calabria.
I've got no update, so I completely missed an update.
Some potential in this move. Promising build-up.
I mean, I'm focusing on the game, but I'm trying to keep an eye out. For West Ham, you guys don't have pie anymore, unfortunately, in the game.
3 minutes to be added on.
Many transfers don't happen.
In this goal advantage, they've now got a corner. The goalkeeper.
How random would that be?
Especially in slow motion.
He someone asked. As well. He feels that a friend of mine asked me about that before. If EA instrumented a system where the game would recognize real-life transfers and then they would happen in-game.
Is that right?
2-0 on the stuff now.
A little bit more comfortable. Good value for this advantage at the moment.
Maybe you were as confused as I was. Here's how he explained
to get into there, so close to goal.
Say someone, say like...
Meat and drink, any good striker. Another one on the tally.
That's good. Yeah.
Restarting.
Let's use Piatt. Sorry about this West Ham fan, but you know he's the best
for half time
example since he's right there. In real life, Piatt has moved back to Marseille. If my friend's system were a real thing, I don't even know if he can do this.
At half time. Off they go for the second.
Possibility. Maybe this is just a crazy idea. It doesn't. That my friend has had, as Emery Moore scores a hell of a goal to make 3-0.
Two for him on the day. And
I
two
completely forgot
well taken goals.
Check what the halftime score scored in the other games.
Another angle on it here.
Damn it. Anyway, how he explains it would be using Dimitri Payet as an example. Since he moved to Marseille, in-game, an update would move him to Marseille. Now, say if you were in West Ham in career mode,
moving forward,
and the update happens after the transfer,
Tackle goes in.
You would still have.
This is how this team can play sustained attacking football, but when they lose it,
but say you were outside the transfer window,
just a risk that they might get caught out. West Ham want to make a change.
Gonna sell Piatt when they
he's coming forward.
As my friend described it, the goalkeeper got a touch. Player would be instantly moved when you. So say if you went into a West Ham career mode that you started post before Piatt had left, and you know he came back on new update, you come onto your career mode.
This is how they love to play.
And Piatt is gone, but you have the money.
I mean,
it kind of makes sense, but it kind of doesn't. Because that would really screw you over. I mean,
to nudge you in the direction.
I can see a massive flaw with that. Like, say, you spent a massive. Like, say, for instance, my purchase of Renato Sanchez. What would happen if Renato Sanchez,
now they've got a
for some reason, left Bayern? I know he just joined Bayern, so it's not
saved
real.
By the goalkeeper at full stretch.
Actually, let's use a different player since he did just join Bayern. So it's probably gonna be a few. He'll probably be at them for a few seasons. Let's use Emre Moore since he's
a good block.
He's kicking ass in this game.
Just working away to try and find.
If Emre Moore were to move clubs. And I asked my friend about this. What would happen if the player is no longer at the team he is at in real life? Say, if Emre Moore were to move to Manchester City or someone like that in the next transfer window, if this system were a real thing,
it'll be fine.
Would I lose Emre Moore because he's at my club?
Into the attacking third.
My friend said,
gets his foot in there. Well, this could be.
And that would probably be down to here. They've got numbers if they did implement this, how they would work that. But you know, that would require them having to know who, what players you bought. You know, I'm assuming maybe they can keep track of how you're working your career mode. I'm assuming there's some way they can check that. Maybe there is. Maybe there isn't. I don't know.
Substitution now for West Ham United.
Fact of the matter is, if that system were a real life thing, that would be really annoying if randomly one of your best, if one of my top young players just randomly move, like in real life. Daniel Sturridge is probably going to be moved on in the summer, so does that mean I would lose him if that were a real system in this game? I mean.
We've got 8 more minutes of the 90. Trying to switch on the attacking power in this situation.
Happens, we'll be gearing up for FIFA 18, but still, that would be a bit annoying.
Look how quick he reacted.
And especially, if the player is a key factor in the world. Like, what if you think the your club didn't get enough money for that player? You just get that you're screwed. And how does it work with when you're playing in a different currency? Because I play with euros because it's the easiest thing for me. Because I'm from Ireland, we use euros. No, I play in the English league. I know you guys use sterling over there, pounds, sterling and pounds. Same thing, but.
Good chunk of added time here. 3 minutes. Obia.
I think it would be a really, really stupid thing. If EA can do that, hopefully they don't.
He's kept it out.
I would mess up a lot of career modes if you just. If you're using a player, he's key to you. And because he moves in real life, he's just gone? No, that shouldn't be the case at all. If a player moves in real life, you should have the option to move him on. getting a nice 2-2 draw.
Aston Villa 2.
Finally, Manchester United did me a favour.
Tottenham Hotspur 2.
And the favour, ironically, is they put me closer to winning the league title.
Newcastle United.
Oh, that's Leicester City 1. Look who's next. Spurs, who are in third place.
West Ham United 0. Manchester City 2.
It's coming. It's coming, lads. It's coming.
Southampton.
That league title.
Swansea City 1. Stoke City 1. Chelsea.
It'll still be a few more.
And let's take a look at what those results mean to the league table. At the top of
the
table.
So don't miss me getting those wins in the next few episodes. Until then, thanks for watching. Homework. Smash the like button and subscribe if you're new.
Fourth, Manchester United with 47 points.
And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice
44 points.
Peace.
In sixth, Chelsea with 44 points, but only behind on goal difference. In seventh, West Bromwich Albion with 39 points. In eighth, Everton with 37 points. Bottom of the table, Derby County with 15 points. And then reading up the table,